All right, guys, so let's get into the properties of a React component. We've discussed the state of a component and also how to update and use the state. And we've started using kind of embedded JavaScript within a return statement, which contains both HTML content and I guess just regular JavaScript like if statements. You can map over properties, and we'll get into all that at some point. For right now, we're going to break out our high score HTML into its own component. So for this, in the source directory, I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to call it highscore.js. Now, as with creating any other React component, the first thing you need to do is import React and component from React, and we're going to create the class with the same name as the file itself. So class high score extends component, and now we are going to build a constructor which actually no let's just create the render method, and we're going to return our beat high score text. So I'm going to copy it and paste it right there, and then at the bottom of the file we're going to say export default high score. Sorry, I just realized that I could zoom in a bit, and that will probably help you guys out. So it's a very simple component. Just we're going to always print out this H3 element for right now. So I'm going to save this. And then in application, we've exported it as high score. So we need to import it as high score. So import high score from. Now it's in the current directory, and it's called high score. And let's remove this. And for right now, we are just going to embed high score. So the way this is done, just like in our index.js file where we wrote application here, and it's that component that we imported, when you embed a component into your other components, it's written like, imagine it kind of like this is an HTML element. So it's self-closing because there's no child elements, and we'll get into that at another point, but you could actually also write it like that. So just using components, embedding them, is very similar to working with HTML. So I'm going to save this, and now I actually need to open up a new terminal and get started again, because I'm recording this on a different day than the last video. So in the demo directory, I just type npm start and hit enter, and it's going to parse the application, it's going to compile it, and then it's going to open a new tab in my browser, which it has just done, and it's loading now. All right, so instantly we see we have a problem. The component is embedded, and it's always printing it out even when we don't beat the high score. Now, something I mentioned previously is the React developer tools. So if you right-click on that, down here in the console that it brings up, there's a new tab called React. So when you click on that, it allows you to inspect the components themselves. See how that says high score? When I right-click on that and go to the right here, it says the properties are an empty object. And so that's a problem. What we need to do is pass it in some properties so that it only displays when it is in fact above 10. So how we do that, you see this onClick event in the button. Use this as a reference, how to use properties. So in HTML, if you want to add an ID to a component, you do this. If you want to add a class to a component, you do that. And that's called a property of a DOM node. Now, just a note, when you're working with classes, like CSS classes in React, the class name is actually reserved in JavaScript using the class property. So you actually have to use class name. And this will apply a CSS class name. So we're not going to do that right now. Right now we're learning how to embed React properties. So in high score, which is a self-closing element, I'm going to drop down to the next line, and I'm going to type in over 10. You can create any property that you want. So in CSS, there are certain properties that do certain things. So you can set a class name or an ID of an element. And there's all the property names that you can use in HTML, for the most part, are predefined. In React, when you're passing properties, you just make them up however you want to. So in this case, we're going to create a property called over 10. And we're going to set it to this state over 10. Now, we're going to, in order to use JavaScript within the return method, you need to wrap it in curly braces. And so that's what we're going to do here. If it's a variable property that you're passing in as a prop, you're going to need to wrap it with these curly braces. Now, I'm going to hit save, and I'm going to go back over to Chrome. And if I right-click on this component here, and then go to React, sometimes it doesn't, but it should like auto-expand to that element. So I'm going to try again. It doesn't really save much time now, but once you get like 30 levels in, it definitely saves time to do it this way. And now you'll see high score over 10 equals false. And if I click on this, on the right hand side, the property is displayed here, over 10 false. Now up on the application level, we see props as an empty object, but we see the state is here. And we can toggle this if it's a true or false. So let's go and click the button. And as we click it, we can see the count is updating in the bottom right. Now, if I go to the high score component, we'll see the property is set to false. If I keep clicking the button, when the state changes on the application, when over 10 becomes true, it will re-render the application component and determine which children components need to be re-rendered with new properties or context. And so in this instance, when we click the button one more time, high score will change. It will re-render with the new property of over 10 equals true, which is all managed by the state of the application. So you'll see that that toggled over to true as soon as I clicked the button. If I come back into this component here and look at the props on the right, over 10 equals true, and then we can, you know, toggle that as well if we wanted to. So it's still displaying high score over 10 all the time, even when we haven't, you know, clicked the button 11 times. And so what we're going to do is go back over to Visual Studio, and into our high score component, we are going to create an if statement. So if this props, so this is how you access the properties of this high score component. If this props over 10, then we're going to return this. Else, now here's an interesting thing. In React, every component needs to return something from the render method. If I just leave this like this, I believe I'll get an error in the console. So let's go back over here. It says nothing was returned from the render. And so that means we always need to return something. And it actually tells you here what to do. If you want to return nothing, return null. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to return null. So I'm going to save. Back over to our component. And I'm going to just click this button. And if I right-click here and inspect the page, we'll see that the component high score is being rendered, but there's no content of that component because over 10 is false. Now keep an eye down here, because what happens is as soon as I hit 11, that component is going to re-render, it's going to reparse that if statement, and it's going to return content now. Beat high score of 10. Now, in React, you can also pass integers, strings, or booleans. You can also pass functions. So I'm going to pass in a function, and it's sort of, well, actually, we've done that right here as well. So onClick is a property that gets sent to that component, and we're going to do the same thing here. So on reset, and again, you can name these whatever you want to, we're going to capture the event, and we're going to kind of pipe it over into this reset count. And we would do this to take in the event, if we wanted to. So now I'm going to write a new method called reset count. That's going to take an event. And in this method, all I'm going to do is reset the state to count is 0 and over 10 equals false. So this dot set state. Count is going to be 0 and over 10 is going to be false. I'm going to save this, and now that we've passed this property in, we're actually going to need to use it here. So in the H3 element, I'm going to create a button, and I'm going to say onClick. So we're going to capture the event, we're going to pipe it over to this props onReset. And I'm just going to make the button say reset. So once we hit 10, or once we hit 11, actually, we'll be able to reset the score. So let's go ahead and jump over to Chrome, and let's have a look at what happens as we click this button. Okay, so now we've got this beat high score of 10. And we see the component rendered here, and there's a button. And when we click this, it's going to reset the parent to 0 and over 10 to false. So reset, and it returns the state of the application to the default, which was 0 and false. Now, by default, this button click takes an event parameter. So what we can do in this instance when the function that calls a property function or another function has the same parameters being input and output, we don't need to do all this fancy jazz. All right, we can just erase this, have the method name, and don't pass in anything. So I'm going to save this, and then an application, just to prove that it still gets the event, I'm going to console log event is, and then E. Now I'm going to save this, and back over to our application. I'm going to need to click this button until we get to 11. And now this reset button is here, and I'm going to go into the console, and I'm going to click reset. And we can see that we did get the event. And that's because, again, this button emits the event as the single parameter. And this function takes in the event as a single parameter as defined right here. Or right here, sorry. Wrong on click. Now we can do this again here as well, because this method takes in the event and the initiating button emits the event as the single parameter. So let's erase this and erase this. So it's just this dot and then the name of the function with no parameters specified. It's going to take care of that automatically. So I'm going to save. We're going to go back to our application. We're in the console. We're going to click until we get to 11. And then we're going to reset, and the event is still passed. So that is working with properties, both methods and variables, and how to use them, and how they work, really, how they automatically update as necessary. And this is part of the reason why React can be so fun to work with, because it manages all the re-rendering and when to do it largely on its own, although we can I guess encourage it to make or not make certain updates as we go through.